Hello, I am Simulated Erk, and this is Simulated Erk Bus Simulator 18, and this is our first night drive. Day one of general release. I've remapped some of my buttons on my side controller, which was a very interesting process, because the funny thing about it is the buttons are mapped, but they don't necessarily tell you what buttons are mapped until you go around pressing buttons and find out, oh, okay, that's the cashier button. Oh, that one opens door one. That one opens door five on buses that have five doors. That's the ignition button. So there's all these different buttons that are mapped, and it recognizes them in the game. But the funny thing is, until you actually go start pressing buttons in the control menus and that sort of thing, that's when you find it. So we'll see how we go, and we'll tweak it if need be. On the first episode, we drove the route, the first route that was set up for us in the tutorial. Now, on this episode, we'll see how far we get, but our current objectives are to drive the existing route at night, which we'll do now, and then paint the bus, create a new route, drive it, expand the existing route, and drive the expanded route. Our reward at the end of all that is 130,000 euros. We're on 20,000 euros now, and apparently we'll also get a new bus. So our first route is basically the same one that we rode and drove in the first episode. Now I want to see if you can actually go out of order. So if I want to paint the bus first and create a bus, let's go to the bus garage. Now we have one bus, we have the Sotaru K. This is our bus that I will show you now. This is our bus. That's the one we drove in the last episode. Two doors. Sotaru K Mercedes-Benz. And it's looking pretty plain, but it's looking pretty sweet. And for a small town that's just establishing its bus service, it's perfect for it. Now you'll see other people who will go out and straight away, as soon as they can buy the biggest bus that they can get with the money that they've got that they've unlocked, they'll go out and get that, whereas I won't necessarily do that in this game. I'm quite happy for the moment, unless an objective really needs it, to run around with a fleet of Sotaru Ks. So let's customize it before we go. Okay, so we can set our primary bus colour. Now, Simulated Erk transport games are red. So I'm going to select red. That looks more orange there, but and our primary colour is red. Our secondary, let's go white. That so does not look red. Maybe this one. Does that look red? Maybe if we set the bus the same colour. Oh, that's better. I don't mind an all red bus. Skins. We'll skip the tutorial. We'll just select our skins. We've got a couple of different skins to choose from at the moment. We've got that one, which I don't mind. We have this one. We just look like a huge ladybug. We look this one, which sort of looks like a fingerprint on the thumbnail. See what I did there? We have this one, which just looks like our bus is all pixelated. we have that one, which I'm, and there's others that are so I'm a massive fan of that. I'm a bit more of a traditionalist. I do. Whoops, hang on, I've gone too far. I'm quite happy for it to be playing at the moment. Ads. We can't unlock any ads at the moment, which is interesting. Okay, so that is our bus, and now we've got some decals. So, all active decals. Add decals, here we go. Do we even need a decal? Oh yeah, bus just looks fine as it is for the moment. That was the other thing I was gonna check. Statistics route planner, employees, bus garage, multi-bus settings. Okay. Statistics, well, we haven't really driven anything yet. Paint the bus, it's ticked. So we're already a little part of the way there. So employees, well, we've only got one bus at the moment, so there's no point. Bus garage, well, there's our Sakari. Okay, let me show you the other buses that you can get. The Cetra 6, the Citara S 416 LOU Business is the next bus that we can unlock. A little bit bigger than the Citara K. I'm looking forward to this one, the Man Lion City A37. I've got that in my modified Grand Theft Auto games, by the way, in some of them. So that's the MAN A37. The Iveco Urban Way. Not too bad. The Mercedes Citara K was the earlier one. This is the G. Like, oh gee, this is a big bus. It's bendy. The 418 business bus. And the big sucker with all five doors. I think I'm going to be quite some time away before I drive that sucker. Alright, so what we're going to do is I'm going to drive the existing route. So we select our route, edit route, well, we don't have to edit that yet. Assign drivers, well, we don't have a driver, that'll be me, and we don't want to remove the route. So this is our route. We start off, where do we start off? Because exactly sure where we start off, but we're going to do it anyway. This should take us 5 minutes, and of course we're going to do it in the Citara K because that's all we have. Oh, hang on, Whoops. I don't want to do any of that. What I wanted to do. And I am now stuck. And nothing is clickable. I am stuck. What have I done? Oh, I hit escape, that's what I did. Yeah, the cockpit C. Get in the cockpit. What I wanted to do, press C, come on. But I need my action button to get into the cockpit. That sounds really strange, doesn't it? I don't even know what button I've got mapped for that. Board cockpit. I don't want to do that anyway. I want to resume drive overview. What I want to abort, that's what I want to do. Yes, what I want to abort. Because I forgot to select to drive at night. Oh, I can turn the cashier off. Sweet. That's awesome. And I can do that route by route. Sweet. I'm going to have to remember that. I hate the cashier function on this game. So now I've got it set for night time, we can start the trip. So let's do that. The bus stop on your route is undergoing maintenance. Your route has changed. Okay. Okay. I only had to drive two stops. Ah, that sound issue is still there from last episode. Which I'm not sure that you can hear. And I think that's a game issue.
Look at all the garbage along the roadside. Why can't people manage their own track?
Next stop is Spoke.
Kneeling's automatic too. So bus stop brake and kneeling are automatic, which were two things that I forgot to do what I,
Next stop, North Spoke.
Which I did on a regular basis in bus M16. Stop at this one, because this bus stop apparently is closed. Closed. Sometimes happen when there's road work around and somebody wants to stop. I should have just stopped anyway, because it didn't actually look like it was closed. Interesting. The people keep on talking about a show called Winter of Passion, and on the subtitle at the bottom of the screen it just said Wizard of Love. So sometimes the subtitle doesn't match what the actual person is saying.
Next stop, North Spoke.
What should I get to eat now? Fast food, junk food.
South Spoke.
I think I'll try some street food.
Getting used to how fast
I
can actually drive the bus.
On the roadside. Why can't people manage their own trash?
We do, my friend, we certainly do.
It was high time that we got a bus route.
Sure is, welcome aboard. Now. action menu. I'm gonna remember which one that's a cashier menu, though I'll be no longer be using. The action menu. Which one did I set for action menu? The ticketing vortex. I'm trapped and I don't know where I am. Our bus, we have finished our first route. Right control. Oops, that did something. Settings. What did I set as my action button? Oh, the menu button. That one. Yep, there we go. Okay, so we indicated when we stopped at a bus stop 5 times. Good bus position. Nailed a bus stop once, but it's supposedly automatic. Use indicator properly 3 times. I thought I used it properly every time. On time at bus stops. None out of 4. A good bus stop position. None out of 5. What? One fare dodger. And $77.80 income on that one ride, which wasn't too bad actually. Finished trip. So we've got a new wrap, a new decal, and a new colour. We have leveled up to level 2, start of level 2. We had one fare dodger there amongst all that. You can actually check people for tickets now. Good bus stop position. I thought my bus stop positioning was pretty good, actually. But anyway. So that's our income. Have a look at our route planner. We've driven the existing route at night, so... while we're on route 1, we'll expand it. We should probably create the new route. Okay, so we'll do that. Hang on. Oh, we will edit the route. A square and then back to actually, well, just change the whole thing. So we'll start at Grana Square, okay, it's Doctor Square, the Media Centre, West Spoke, East Spoke, and Astro Promenade. So we'll do that. And we'll, what does that say? Click here to change the route name. Astra, whoops. This is going to be cool too. Astra Prom and Aid. Aid via. Astro Promenade via Media. Not used to the American spelling. Optimize the route. Looks pretty good. So it says that we've already expanded the existing route, Route 1, and so now I'm going to drive it. So you can go out of order. Like, I painted the bus before I drove the existing route at night, and now I'm expanding the existing route before and driving it before I create a new one, which to me makes logical sense. Let's start our drive. Daytime. Sunny and rainy. There we go. We'll do that. Quick start on, cashier off, too early on, simplified, Sitar okay, let's do it.
At least I don't need the water. I hope I'll be able to catch some sleep along the way. Thank you. turn off the stove. Did you see the last episode? No. Don't spoil it for me. Sometimes I feel like I'm in a game. Thank you.